off wishing outside. If you cry my car, then we're here all night. A couple blunts rolled and I got my windows down. Shit, it's been a while since you've been this high.
Oh, shit.
We're fucking back, baby.
Fuck, yeah, this is... Mallow.
What the fuck?
This is already chaos.
Whose dog's this? Oh, shit.
Hey, bro.
Hey, bros.
It's good to be back, baby.
Yeah, for sure, man. Holy shit. It's been too long, man. I've been trying to tell you it's been too long, bros.
Cheers,
cheers, cheers, cheers, cheers. Cheers, 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 cheers.
Grassing a few reds. After
it's been too long.
This is going down too well, son.
Whose dog's this?
Okay, no, I'll deal with Mello. You keep
nah, fuck Mello. It's sweet. Let Mello right? run around, ruling.
Run around, bubba. Welcome back to Grouse and a Few Reds episode, whatever the fuck we're up to now.
I think it's five or five. I think
five or
we'll
six.
Call it five. Yeah.
Bubba, get down. Go away.
Bala Mello.
Bala Mello. What have you been doing, man? Give the people what they want. The people's podcast is back.
The people's podcast is back, and I'm first of all, I just want to say, you know, grateful. I'm grateful, very grateful at the moment, as always. Grateful for you, grateful for the opportunity, grateful for Ice,
yep.
Grateful for the team, grateful for baby girl, grateful for family.
Yeah, nice.
And
I wanted to just say something before we rip all the way into this, because we've got a jam-packed show, as we always do. Interaction Podcast of Doom, Doozy members, we are going to be giving away this entire Life Appreciation Club collection to one member later on, so we're going to be getting on those phones, man. And who knows, we might call a few more people.
Let's just call people.
We might give away this fucking sign, because God knows it's not staying there.
I want to give away heaps.
Heaps, yeah.
I don't know if we're allowed to. I don't think so,
well,
but...
he left Mello here, so...
it is what dog, it is. You want to win a dog.
But I also want to say that we did hear you guys. The calls for Grouse and a Few Reds to come back were deafening.
Crazy.
You know what I mean? That's all I heard for the last 2 weeks, but...
Crazy.
We were doing the best we could with what we were given, because what we were given, or at least one of us, was COVID-19, baby. I don't want to go down too far down this rabbit hole, Geordie, but obviously people need to know the reason why we weren't here. What happened, man?
Well, obviously, as everyone knows, or if you haven't heard yet, that Ice got fucking COVID, COVID-19, formerly known as the coronavirus. And obviously he was in the office, so we couldn't come in the office for 14 days. A few of you guys had to quarantine. It's a little bit reckless, you know. It's a bit reckless. I mean, yeah, maybe he thought he was better than the virus. and I wouldn't put it past him.
He
too.
Certainly thinks he's better than this show, which is why he leaves us here and we have to do everything our fucking selves. So
yeah, so I mean, yeah, but I'm happy that he, you know, all seriousness, I'm happy that he recovered quickly, and I'm happy he didn't really do much to him. So,
but I was genuinely shocked that none of us got it. Like, I know I was the only close contact, but like we were still all. Even though we do the whole fucking two in, two out, social distance shit, like, you would still expect fucking, we're both shoving our faces into Mello's head every 2 seconds, like.
Yeah, well, that's the reason that's the reason why I wasn't coming into the office much, so, I mean.
You also weren't coming in because you were having a little sook.
Well, no, it's because you cunts were being all willy-nilly with fucking, anyways. No, yeah, but we are essential workers.
Yeah, we are.
I'll
tell you what, man, if this podcast isn't essential, I don't know what is.
Like a fucking 12 o'clock, midday, like 1 o'clock, you know, so for that early dinner / late lunch.
Yeah.
And getting absolutely blind and not even eating.
And calling me at 4:30 saying, brother, where are you? And I'm like, holy fuck.
I miss it, man.
I'm still at work, man.
I fucking miss it, bro.
Yeah.
That's one thing that I'm keen to do, is just go out for a late lunch and get absolutely shit-faced and fucking...
Surely this fucking lockdown ends soon, man. Like, I know we're not... This is very much not a political podcast. We're not going to get into all that shit, but holy cunt, man. Enough's enough.
It's hard, man, because, you know...
I don't... Like, I'm dumb. I don't have the answers. I'm just...
This
can't be the way to do it.
I have the answers. you know, I like to follow...
I know you follow
I like
the news.
To follow the news and follow what's going on in the world right now. And there's just obviously... There's two sides of the fence, right? And I feel like... people just don't want to, you don't want to take a risk and then, you know, someone close to you gets hurt. You know what I mean? Even though that it's not real, like ice got it.
Yeah.
And, you know, I feel like people, not like obviously from a monetary standpoint, people get affected by it, which is fucked.
Yeah.
But, you know, there's always two sides to the story.
Got to learn to live with it, man.
Anyways.
You know what I was, oh, fuck, sorry, bro.
It's all right.
Fucking hell.
Are you sweet?
Sorry, bro. When we first got the call, well, got the call, it was only you and I in here, yeah, when Isaac messaged that. No, it was just you and me, eh?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so he basically we were...
I was in my car.
No, when he texted us, you were in here with me.
Oh, no, no.
Yeah.
I wasn't a close contact.
No, I know, but not of me. You guys were secondary, right? So you don't have to try cover yourself. You're not in trouble.
Whoa, don't try to get me locked down.
Hey, what's the next song? But I'll tell you what, the hardest part, obviously you want your mate to be healthy. That was number one. Bro, you know I don't do well when I'm away from you for too long anyway, but
no one
isolation,
does. No one does.
Isolation, bro, I was going fucking crazy, man. Like, the miso was obviously the same as you and Hoz and all that was secondary, so she got a negative test and then was sweet to fucking swan around, do whatever, which is weird. That's a weird rule in itself.
So weird.
That I have to lock up, but she doesn't.
Yeah, it's
crazy. But anyway, like, she would get home, bro, and, like, I hadn't talked to anyone other than on the phone to you all day.
Mm-hmm.
I must have been the most annoying fucking bloke to live with because I just needed to talk to someone, bro. I was going fucking crazy. Weird, well, eh?
It is weird. I did a 14-day quarantine. You have to really dig deep to, you know, not go off the fucking rails.
But you didn't even realize it. You didn't realize.
But yeah, fuck, I tell you what, man. Fuck.
You don't even realize it's happening. Like, you go off the rails, it just starts to fucking.
Yeah, you don't even know, man. You don't even know. You can fucking wank about fucking 12 times a day and you just.
Even that, like, after a while, you just.
Yeah, like, how much porn can you watch?
Oh. Oh, shit. I love how this shit just randomly plays. Daddy, go. Fuck, this is a good show, man. Oh.
Cheers, mate. Cheers. It's good to see you again, bro. Really fuck, is. Man. Welcome back, man.
Thanks, brother. I was saying to the boys, like, normally sort of set it on 10 out of the can. You have a new appreciation for Jordan Simi when you're away from him for a long time. The jokes actually start to hit. The charm hasn't completely worn off. Because I think if we're being honest with each other, we were getting a little bit sick of one another right before the lockdown.
No.
Just me?
I mean, I'm getting sick and tired of you, all of you guys as a collective because...
Hating on you.
This
actually brings me to my next point, Jordy. I don't mean to interrupt you, but you're wearing a very nice piece of merch right now that's still for sale. Jordan's Room is running Jordan's for the rest room. Of the month, so another week.
Yeah, one more week to jump on. It's a lifestyle, really. It's not for everyone.
No.
But when you wear my merch... People look at it and they know straight away. They go, holy shit, that guy is about that life.
5BK.
That chick's about that life.
Yeah.
It's a tie. It's a suit. It's Superman's cape that you're putting on. And I'm not saying it's just from me. Like, it's just a way of life.
And that was obviously, we've touched on it enough. And if you haven't checked out Outside Wake ATI yet and you're a Doozy Club member, jump on because it's a fucking giggle. Simi and Scope sort of dove into it a little bit more. But that was one design that you got across the board. A couple of other ones you didn't. And so I threw down there because I wanted you to bring this up. Simi has taken the design process into his own hands.
I tried to explain to everyone. I have worked in fashion for years.
Give us that resume, baby.
I have worked in fashion for years. I was the national sales manager for fucking Nautica.
That's not a GRB that he actually was.
I was the face of Nautica.
You know, okay. What hit different before the Nautica was real estate, Simi. That hit different. Anyway, continue.
I was a sales manager for Ray White, Queensland. Yeah. Well, it felt like it anyways. I was killing it.
Commission.
But I don't enjoy it, though. So if you don't do, if you do something, even if it's good money, you don't enjoy it, don't do it because it's not going to last long.
Mm.
Anyways, so the designs that have, is like snuck through the cracks of YKTR are fucked because I have a vision, right? And my shit is fucked up. Like, it's different.
It's different.
It's same, but it's different though. And I'm just going to give you guys a perfect example, right?
And I actually like...
You were right there.
Yeah, show me, yeah. I'm your biggest hater, but you know that I enjoyed this one. But show it and then I want you to walk me through kind of the design process.
Fun. All right. Well, Here you go here. Let me just come up a little bit.
Yeah, go right up.
Let me just come up a little bit.
I'll spin this so you can still pour. And he's just done this with a fucking magic marker in 10 minutes of spare time. Get that detailed shot, baby. Yeah.
Anyways, I've named this hoodie Baby Girl's hoodie, right? Baby Girl inspires not just me, but Baby Girl inspires everyone.
Yeah.
Right? So this is for, you know, the missus when she's cold. She's chilling at home.
Maybe she's in the kitchen washing that pan that you left out last night.
Exactly.
Little ass cheek sticking out the bottom of it.
This shit is fucking fire.
It's actually vibey as, yeah.
It's like,
I hope the camera did it justice then. Looked overexposed as shit.
I know. Yeah, like just from here, maybe you can zoom up on the cunt. But I'm telling you right now, it's fucking fire, man.
That's one and of one too.
That's one of one.
You want that? Like, this is the thing.
I'm going to give it away to
We're
going to call someone and say they've won. That's my new canvas right now because I can't paint at the moment because of lockdown. But these hoodies have become my new canvas. I'm going to fucking draw on these cunts and we're just going to give them away.
That's an XL. That's one of one. And look, the registered retail price of that, let's 2.5, 3K?
Whatever. Yeah, I'd probably say $2,000 to $3,000.
$3,000 just because, like, we're not money hungry. Like, we're not fucking, like, we just want to give them away for what they're worth. So I'd say actually, 3K.
I'm actually a fashion icon of fucking Australia, and I hate to say it, and I don't mean to be like, I'm just confident in myself, all right?
I can't disagree.
I just know that fashion-wise, whatever I touch, it just turns to fire.
I'm dying over here.
So anyways, I'm just saying that's where my head's at for the designs. So, that's where my head's at.
The way this works, right, so Simi, so Jordan, and I don't want to give away air too much of the dirty laundry, but anyway, Simi gets a bunce from YKTR, but he also gets a bunce off merchandise.
Merch, yeah.
Which is why he's so passionate about it, but it's also a reflection of you, mate. So when you say to you...
100%.
You don't... 100%.
100%.
So he's been a little bit grumpy with some of the final products. Not that one. You like the one you're rocking now.
Oh, yeah, I love this one. Yeah. I designed it.
Yeah, exactly. So you've taken that into your own hands. That's fire.
I understand.
If it wasn't in a kiddie's fucking Ace Color XL, I'd be rocking it too. Oh, mate. That shit's a wetsuit on me.
I understand that, you know, podcast merch and designer shit is different, right? But not in my eyes. Not in my eyes. I'm not looking for, a quick fix. I want people to get it.
Yeah.
Wait there. Sorry, I got to read this. Cunt's sending me shit all the time.
What?
Oh, okay. Never mind. I just saw these fucking TikToks. These fake TikToks coming out of me fucking dating this bloody chick.
Talk about that.
I don't even know where these people get this fucking info from.
It's me.
Like, no, but like, it's so far. I've met her once.
Yeah.
And I wish I was dating that girl.
Yeah.
She fucking looks stunning. She looks funny. She looks amazing.
She does. She looks like she knows a way around a red wine.
I genuinely feel like I would enjoy her company, but that's neither here nor there. It's not even reality.
Because it's not reality, so we don't have to talk about it too much. But what I did want to touch on before we sort of roll into the show, and if you are still sticking around, you're a duty member, stay by that phone, man, because here we come.
Pick up the phone.
But I wanted to touch on this because it's a good thing, but it's also a giggle. I don't know why it's a giggle, but Simi and Scope have got themselves new little buns. I don't know how much you can talk about it, but I'm going to give you anyway.
I won't get into it from a monetary...
No, but just who is it? Point. What are you doing?
So we get a call.
How the fuck did it come about?
We get a call from this company, close friends with Ice and YKTR, cool people, and they just say, hey, listen, we've got an opportunity because we're in the betting scene and all that jazz, punters club and whatnot. We have an opportunity for you guys to team up with a esports betting company called Picklebet. And
I know I'm not laughing at Picklebet. I think it's an interesting name, but it's just like whatever.
It rolls. If you provide the jam, it then rolls. A name's a name. So
do you think, bro? Do you think so the fact that you're the Oracle had anything to do with you getting on their radar?
Yeah,
I mean, I'm just trying to put two and two together here.
It definitely does. So. Now we've got an opportunity to fucking, work with this esporting betting company, which is, it's massive.
Fuck, such a cool space in terms of like potential growth. Holy cunt.
And then they, you know, we want to jump on board and do more with them. So I think the future's looking bright in that regard.
Yeah. And they obviously give you a little buzz as well.
If you guys haven't heard of it,
jump on and download it, man.
Go jump on, download Picklebet. Odds are really good. It's all esports, bit of sports in there. Check it out for sure.
But you know, I was thinking, especially in lockdown, like when there's not as many sports to bet on.
100%. Esports is the way to actually make money because the odds are crazy.
Are you and Hozzy going to be doing any of the live streaming stuff yet, or you haven't got that across the line?
Well, we have got that across the line. So we will be doing some esports scope versus semi. Mm. Obviously, it's lockdown right now, so we can't really go out and so fuck, esports is literally like the call to arms right now.
That's sick. And I don't want to take full credit for putting you on the radar with this podcast, but I accept your thank you anyway, just in advance. Fuck, bro, my arm is fucking... My arm is cooked. This is...
Oh, my God.
This is a nice segue too because... And I'm again, this isn't a COVID podcast. We're not pro or anti anything, but I got my vaccination yesterday. The funny thing about it was I went the old AstraZeneca.
Yeah.
Simi got the jab, 4 weeks ago?
I got it 4 weeks ago, and before everyone starts blowing up and calling me sheep,
that's our personal
like that.
Fucking choice, man.
Yeah, it's a personal choice, but I've got like my kids are up in Queensland, and
if getting vaccinated means you can go up and see them,
exactly. I can't see them at the moment because of it. So at the end of the day, fuck, I've put a lot worse into my body than fucking some weird COVID thing. Yeah. So if that means I get to go see my children, then I don't give a fuck.
I was in the same boat. If getting vaccinated means I get to go home and see my old boy in there,
I don't care. Man, you're like, fuck.
Yep.
You're going to die eventually anyway. So.
In saying that, I thought I was going to die last night. So Simi messaged me yesterday. So basically the way this works at YKTR, especially when we're planning the greatest podcast under the fucking network, is we kind of have a bit of planning in the afternoon beforehand.
Yeah.
So I say to Simi, this is what we're doing. And Simi's had a big day today. He's had 3 pods and a meeting and he's designing his own merch. Big day. So I said, bro, what did I say to you? I said, you need to bring that fucking energy. And you went, yep, cool, got it. And then you said, what are you doing tomorrow? And I said, oh, well, I got to get the jab in the afternoon. And you went, bro, you're not going to.
No, I go, what one? And he just fucking said Astra. And I go, oh, bro, you're not in tomorrow.
Yeah.
And he goes, you know, and I'm actually quite proud of you, man, for coming in today.
Thanks, man.
No, you were told to come in, eh?
Yeah, I got bullied.
So.
Hang on, just quickly before you continue. I messaged Isaac in the morning, same thing as you. I said, hey, bro, can't make it in today, scene. So I rolled in at 9. Anyway, continue.
You feel bad, eh?
I felt like, so fuck, bad. I was like,
bro, so good, man. Yeah. And I go, you're not in tomorrow. And he goes, nah, I'm not a pussy, blah, 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 because I was fucked after I got it.
Yeah, you carried on.
And then I messaged him in the morning. I was like, good morning, Jackson.
Which pissed me off anyway, because you never call me by my full name.
No, but the thing is, you never wake up to positivity. I'm always complaining about something. I'm always like, fuck, man, I need this. And these are messages at like 2, 3 o'clock in the morning, because that's when I wake up.
It's the worst.
So I knew he was going to be fucking already fucked anyway, so I wanted to be positive today. I messaged him. I'm like, hey, man, how you feeling? He's like, fuck. He's like, I hate you. I woke up this morning hating you. And I was like, mate, make sure you bring that fucking energy today, mister.
That you were talking about yesterday.
I've got so much on my plate. I've got so much business opportunities and things just falling on my plate right now. And
it's a full bucket.
It's a fucking full bucket. And you have to juggle energy. You can't just be spreading it willy-nilly, right?
I'm sweet now, but I was not in a good way this morning, man. I haven't been that crook in a hot minute, but is what it is. Got the jab. I'm 4 weeks. I'm getting the next one, so who gives a fuck?
Yeah.
I don't really care too much about it. Fresh songs added to the playlist. Again, before we roll on, jump on Grouse and a Few Reds. Is that just the name of the playlist?
That's it.
Grouse and a Few Reds. All your favourites, all your podcast classics. You know how we roll. Fresh music updated everywhere.
I put some new music in there, right? This is for fucking...
It's that Friday drive home, so...
Yeah, Friday drive home, or you're in lockdown and you just look at your fucking partner or housemate and you go... Let's have a beer.
Yeah.
Let's have a few reds, right?
It's easy listening too.
Easy, very easy. It just flows like a motherfucker. Just chuck it on shuffle.
Yeah. That's what I do every episode. It just plays. Do you want one more before I
yeah, sure. Yeah, yeah, I'd love one.
Yeah. All right, bro. Give it 2 seconds.
Hey, hey, hey. Oh, well, you're... Fuck off, man. Fuck, Ice is a smart ass. That cunt wasn't my boss, I'd smack that cunt. The funny thing is people don't know this, right? People don't know this.
Yeah.
Ice and I are actually tight as, and he might not admit it, but who's the cunt that's always with him fucking on the desk?
What did I just do with my desk? Oh.
You know what I mean?
I'm going to tell you, he missed you. I could tell this morning he was all excited about you coming in. He was giggling away at the content. You're now the feature of his new vlog series, which he snuck up on all of us.
Yeah, I might tell him to pull the pin on that because I don't want to be on it. I don't want to be on that shit.
I don't want to be carrying that shit.
I don't want to be carrying that shit. How many fucking podcasts do I need to carry? How many vlogs?
Yeah. No, he's bully season's in full effect, but I think he's turned around full circle.
You know what? I'll say this straight up, right?
Mm.
Because this is from the heart too. Okay.
So yeah, I'm listening, man. Sorry.
I was sitting there with baby girl on Sunday, and I just, you know, I've been chatting to my kids. I've been speaking to my mom, my family back home. Fucking shit was popping. So I just looked at baby girl, and I was like, man, this is the happiest I've been in a long, long time. You know, just content.
Yeah.
Just very happy with, I had no stress on my mind anywhere.
And then. And you haven't had that in a long time.
Not a long time, you know me. So then anyways, I was just like, man, you know, the opportunity that I've been given here at YKTR is unmatched, right? Mm. And fucking that cunt, shut the fuck up.
Bro, those stairs must be the biggest job in Sydney because those cunts have been on that.
They're like welding. They're like making the stairs.
For 6 months.
Handmade stairs. Handmade stairs. These cunts.
And you were just getting into a nice moment, too.
And I just looked at baby girl. I messaged Ice out of the blue, and I just said, mate, you know, thank you. Thank you for giving me the opportunity. Thanks for fucking taking me under the YKTR umbrella. And I was like...
What was his reply?
Man, nothing. He left me on scene. But that's not the point. Cunt thinks he's too good to message me back anyways. I was blind, so I didn't mean it. But
is that when you FaceTimed me? Was that Sunday?
Fuck, I was blind, man. Oh, fuck, man. I was blind.
You were both zinging.
I love that shit, man. Anyways, but yeah, I just wanted to say, you know, thanks. Because, you know, I'm moving out soon. I've got a place.
Yeah?
Yeah, in Point Piper.
Where's, I don't know where that is.
That's in, like, by Double Bay.
When you say you've got a place.
I've got it. Actually, it's all... Done. Sealed, done deal.
Signed, sealed, delivered.
Yeah.
When do you move in?
In 4 weeks. I'm not even joking.
I don't believe you.
No, because one of my connections actually hooked me up.
Oh, shut up.
See, you're not welcome.
Can we do live? Can we do Grass and Reds live from your place in 4 weeks?
Yeah, but don't. You're not welcome now because you fucking just.
So I'll zoom you in.
So, but no, honestly, I was just like, that happened as well. And I was like, holy shit, like. Life's been hard these past 3 years. And I was like, you know what? If I have to put it on three people, four people actually that played a big role in getting me back on track with life
mm-hmm.
is, you know, obviously Ice, Normie, Chico, Scope.
Yep.
Massive. Yeah. And I'm fucking so grateful. And I think that just these grateful teas
mm.
is where I'm going with this.
We'll see you at 6 o'clock.
We'll see you at 6 o'clock. Nah, but I was just like, holy shit, man. Life is so good, man. Life is so good. Yeah, so
it took a punt on me as well, bro. Like with, you know, people probably know the story, but like the YKTR Sports was an idea that was birthed from myself, Isaac, and Luke 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And 2 years ago, I basically said to him, I said, the second the company's in a position to pay me, I'll get on the flight.
Yeah.
And he goes, like, how much are you on now? And like, I probably can't match that. I said, I don't care. If I get enough to pay bills and fucking a couple of omelets with Simi every other day, I'll move over.
Mm.
And then, you know, when he decided he may have a bit of wiggle room to do that, and I just booked a flight and sprung it on the car.
Yeah.
Hey, let's be honest, probably delayed you and Hoz getting on the payroll a little bit.
Bro, straight up, yeah.
By coming on taking your bus.
Fuck this nerd, bro. I can write a few blogs here and there. Can't spell for shit, but I'll do it.
But so grateful, man. Like, and I know it's shit at the moment, and I know lockdown sucks for everyone.
Sucks for everyone.
But the fact that you and I get to come in here, we get to smack a few beers, listen to some old 80s music, talk a bit of shit, and give away some clothes.
I think this, yeah,
it's thing, not a bad life, man.
The thing for me, I was like, I can wake up in the morning. I can go for a fucking Bondi to Bronte. I can go for a swim with a baby girl, enjoy my breakfast.
She much of a swimmer?
Yeah, loves the water, a little dolphin.
Yeah, gone.
And I just was like, fuck, man. We've got, you know, the best. This is
This is living.
This is living, you know. So it's only going to get better. But not to rub it into anyone, but I'm just grateful for.
I think you're allowed to rub it into anyone because you've been on the other end of that for a hot minute now, and it was as entertaining as it was for all of us. It was hard. It was a hard watch.
Man, I didn't just get handed this fucking thing. I've been in and out of YKTR for about 5 years now.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm just fucking bro. I'm stoked, man.
People definitely prefer Ben to Simi. But I tell you what right now, and I'm not speaking out of turn here, Sim, the second this lockdown shit ends and we can throw an event, we're going to push the boat all the way out.
Yeah, bro. Yeah.
And it only, I don't see why.
I'm doing a fucking Australia-New Zealand tour.
Yeah, that's why. I think we're going to go on a live podcast tour and obviously sell out everywhere we go. But you're going to have to be, Doozy members are probably going to have to get first crack of tickets because they're going to sell like fucking hotcakes.
I honestly, bro, like, this lockdown, I've already planned it out in my head. I'm doing Brisbane, Gold Coast, Sydney. Oh no, I'll do Brisbane, Gold Coast, Auckland.
Mm.
Wellie.
Back to Sydney.
Finish on Sydney. Right? I'm going to do a tour. Whoever wants to jump in.
It's like the fucking Tour de France. You join in halfway through if you want.
I'm literally going out. And this is the thing as well. I want people to know this, right? Is I... Because everyone's like, who's this fucking random guy that just comes on and gives people worldly advice that he doesn't even take himself? I'm just one of you guys that have been given an opportunity.
Yeah.
That's the best way I can
put it. Oh, that reminds me. Continue. Sorry. We should get the while you're talking, I'm going to get the speak pipe, the fucking Jordan's Room hotline messages. We got a fuckload that we didn't get to. So we'll get to those before we call.
Have you listened to them?
Yeah, there's a few that are a fucking giggle.
So I just...
Continue. Sorry, bro.
I just... I'm grateful for everyone who also fucking supports me as well. Supports me, follows my content, backs me. And yeah, I mean, I can't be fucking grateful enough. So,
bro, there's so many in here.
Keep rocking. Yeah, I know, bro. I keep getting emails and shit.
Before we get on to that, this is going to be a long potty. What are we at to? Holy cunt. Yeah, we're going to be rolling. But before we get on to that, you mentioned briefly the little dolphin. Baby girl, we always like to come in here. Before we give relationship advice, I think it's only fucking fair that we give a little relationship update ourselves. Mm. You know me, mate. I'm golden.
Yeah, we're
humming along. No dramas. Obviously, I was probably the most annoying cunt in Sydney while I was in ISO, but she managed to put up
and
with
out
that.
Of ISO too,
and she
pissed me off.
And she was sitting there on the bedside last night while I was having the fucking cold sweats of doom, and she was patting me with the old cold flannel. So. Wifey doing the same shit, man. Doing
that
wifey shit. Make up a little pumpkin soup. You know, warm the soul.
Yeah, nice.
You know,
that's lovely, bro.
Maybe a little hand job in the sheets, something like that.
Yeah, that's nice.
Just to get you up and going in the morning.
Yeah, that's fucking beauty.
So, I never have much of a relationship update for you, Sim. Other than we're pretty much rolling along. She's
of course,
living,
you're married,
living the best
you're married.
Life.
You guys are a solid team, man. You know what you want.
Yeah, we know what we want, and
it's hard to find.
Basically, the All Blacks are relationships. So, how's everything going with you, man? How's baby girl?
I'd say the Wallabies of relationships right now. Respectfully,
showing signs of promise, but getting fucking
just
beat up.
Fucking, we've got a good front row, but. Holy cunt, we need a 10 and a fucking 15, man. I tell you what.
Respectfully, Lonnie.
I'm joking. That cunt's nice. But I sometimes, you know, you just don't know what's going on sometimes. You know what I mean? Females are so hard to understand.
Yeah.
And, you know, sometimes chicks, they want you to be somewhat jealous. They want you to be somewhat... You know, take that role, but then sometimes they're like, whoa, whoa, whoa. And then, so, like, they want you to be affectionate, but then they don't want you to be affectionate.
Yeah.
So you've got to almost.
And they go, oh, you're too cool. And you're like,
fuck.
You called me clingy 2 months ago.
Yeah, yeah. So you're just like, you've got to try and find the balance, right? And I mean, obviously, one, grateful for the opportunity.
Mm.
It's hard to find people out there that make you think like this, but then also, two, is like, shit. I have no idea what the fuck I'm on about. We're talking about relationships and shit, but everything's sweet.
Yeah,
everything is sweet. It's just early days, you know. You can
be honest, man. Don't worry about it.
Yeah,
no,
well, I'm just saying. No, it is sweet, but I'm just saying, like, it's hard. It's hard. It's hard because things are just they're blooming. You know,
it's
it's almost like a strawberry bush. you've got to water it consistently in order to grow your fruits.
Yeah.
So if you're not...
Or if you're scope, you just water the artificial wall like you did today.
If you're not watering it consistently, then you're not going to get, you're going to get bad fruit.
It's dry out there, man.
So, but yeah, I mean, fuck. I don't fucking...
Oh, shit. Fucking chaos in here. All right, well, give it... I think it's time for you to give a bit of relationship advice.
I'd love to.
As always, these Jordan's Room Hotline, will put the Instagram bio, I mean the, what do you call it?
One of ones.
We're going to give that away. I don't give a shit.
I want to give this to someone.
But are you ready for a bit of relationship advice, Jordy? I'm just going to play this randomly. I don't know what it is. Yeah. Can you hear, you can hear the sweet.
Have you listened to all of them?
Nah, there's so
well,
many.
Hopefully
as well.
That they're not, we'll cut it out if it's
yeah.
fine.
Nah, we won't. All right.
Hey legends, quick question. A friend and I invited a guy over and obviously said, hey, there's two of us, bring a friend. He did, a hot one at that. Oh. So they arrived and everything was great. We eventually got a little frisky, well, attempted to. After a while, one said, I can't get hard, and the other one immediately laughed and agreed. I'm not saying we're 10 out of 10s, but we're not ugly and us girls haven't had this issue before.
Oh,
eventually they got hard, but it was more of a task than an easy hookup. Mm. You think it'd be all good after that? No. Between the two of them, they kept losing their stiffies. Once they left, us girls got talking. When we just want to know, was it us or was it the fact that they were trying to fuck us in the same bed? Our egos took a hit that night, so any advice would be great.
I love this hotline, man. There's
fucking females on the hotline now.
So, Simi, let me sum this up before you give advice. Yes. It sounds like maybe a little social media dating app hookup.
Yeah, they've connected.
They've said, hey, listen, I'm with my mate. If you've got any friends with you, bring them along. I'm going to go out on a limb and say footy players. Just in the ballpark.
Maybe, yeah, maybe.
You know what I mean?
Maybe.
They go two by two, hurrah.
They do, yeah, they do, yeah.
And they get there, maybe a bit of grouse and a few reds, and all of a sudden can't get it working. Before you give these lovely women advice, first of all, it's not you guys. They're trying to say, is it us? We're not 10 out of 10s, but never had this problem before. It's not you girls. But have you ever had this problem, Sim? Performance
issues. Before I give my two cents, I want to say to the females, thank you for trusting us with this information.
That was a really good one.
And that's what I love about females. They're not like, they don't, they just tell it how it is and they're open to discussing these things. So thank you.
Thank you.
Secondly, I would like to say it's definitely not the girls, right? And the guys wouldn't be there if they didn't think that it was worth it, right?
That's a good point.
I actually commend the boys because it tells me one thing, that they don't do this often, because if they're getting shy in front of each other, then that means that it's not really their type of territory.
Same bed's a different beast.
Well, yeah, it is a different beast. It
takes a special,
but
kind of
it means that there's, you know, there's care factor in there. There's like there's overthinking. Mm. So it's actually a good thing that the boys potentially got a bit nervous, because that means that they haven't done it that much, or they just,
that's a good positive sign.
So that's about that really.
What causes potentially?
Well, you overthink things, right? Yeah. I'll go off straight off the bat.
You get in your own head.
Yeah, you get in your own head. I mean, even one-on-one sometimes, you know, like I'm not a one-night stand type of guy. I like to get to know someone. So potentially if it was like willy-nilly, the two boys jump in.
We've all got a past, that's fine. Yeah.
The two boys jump in and they're like, shit, like, I'm nervous, you know.
Well,
you overthink things.
The part where they've lost me a little bit is I get the initial startup phase. Starting the lawnmower is always hard, but cutting out halfway through?
Cutting out halfway through
what
means you're overthinking.
Same thing.
You're overthinking. You're thinking, shit, you know, maybe you and the bro haven't had like a little swingers vibe, and you're thinking, fuck, I'm nervous.
Yeah.
So it's nothing bad on both ends. It's just like, shit, it's just new territory maybe.
Yeah. I like it. That's good advice. I mean, I'm going to lean on you for this one. So that's good.
I've never been in that situation.
This one is only 4 seconds long, so I'm nervous to play it because I feel like it's just going to be someone yelling. But
I don't even reckon we play it.
Okay, let's just jump straight to the next one then. Here we go.
Kia ora, Jordan and Jacko. Nicole here from over in New Zealand. Sure. Hey, first, love you guys together. Love the podcast with you too. It's great.
Thank you.
I'm just calling with a thought I've had from the start, and just thought I'd let you know, Jordan, and take it or leave it. So I know that when you first started, you were all about love and relationship advice and stuff like that. And when you first started, like, you had some hot Sydney chicks on there. Like, they were amazing. And I love listening to them, especially as a female. But I know that you're asking for advice for like your listeners. And my thought's always been like your average YKTR listener is like an average Joe, like, you know, working a trade and probably not mixing with the most elite crowd, you know, like
that's
mixing with normal people. Not that anyone's better off or worse off than anyone. And I've always thought that when you do the advice part, especially if you're going to bring a female back on again, I feel like a female who was in the same playing field would probably help. And look, yeah, obviously I'd love that to be myself, but like
someone
who's been through the ringer, learnt some shit and wants to pass it on and help out, but from a slightly less like high, you know, standard maybe. That's just my thought. I'm probably way off, but anyway, love you guys. Cheers.
Kia ora, Nicole. Thank you very much.
Love you too. That's, you know what, to have two females back to back, I love that.
Yeah, that's weird. I know, it I think shows, three after.
It actually shows the direction we're going is a positive way, because if females feel open enough to speak on Jordan's Room, Grouse and a few Reds, then we're doing something right.
Yeah, I agree.
Because so females don't just jump on anything willy-nilly.
Was her point was her point that she's thinking maybe you need to get someone a bit more realistic before you give an advice? Because like, let's be honest, bro. Jordan's Room, the highlight reel in terms of who you've had on, it's pretty extraordinary.
Well,
so
I just so the thing is for me, right? You come from I totally understand her.
Yeah, okay.
But I'll come from a business point of view first. Right? It's the thing for me.
Hey, we're in the content game.
The thing for me, right, is I don't come from like a heavy footy background. I don't come from like an influencer background. I'm just a normal random cunt.
Just a normal guy
who loves to party
with a blue tick.
Exactly. But so for me, that was to build the downloads, because in order to ask someone for something, so it'd be for me asking the crowd to listen and download and buy a t-shirt, then I've also got to give them something worth listening to. So I mean, not that no one's worth listening to, but if you have someone with more of a status, you are more inclined to have people listen.
Yeah.
So my goal at the end of this is like to be able to get a normal fucking Tom, Dick and Harry random person, and people are open to just listening to it because I've built that trust with them.
Right.
But if I'm just getting, you know, a random person on the get-go, people are just going to say, who the hell are these two characters?
I'm not going to listen to Jordan Simi with fucking Bob Smith.
I'm not a nobody. I'm a nobody, and you know, and I get someone who doesn't have like that status for people to be engaged with.
Yeah.
So, but I get where she's coming from. But that is my goal, though, is to be able to bring on, you know, just a normal everyday person and speak about, you know, everyday things. But right now, it has to be people with somewhat of a status, you know. And here and there, I'll chuck on this person, that person. But you know, unfortunately, the world we live in, people want to get something back from it.
I also think that was a good call. I quite like that one. But I also think as well, just because of the you know, 10 out of 10, the following, all the whatever, the people that you get on, their advice transcends that type of people. Like, and the advice you try and offer is general. You're saying fucking the $1 million footy player and the fucking 40K a year road construction worker, the advice should go across. Oh, fuck.
Shit. Who's that?
The photographer.
Oh, cunt.
But yeah, I agree with you.
Yeah, so no, I get her. So eventually it will get to that. But, you know, people are more inclined to listen and download if...
there's a bit of a base there.
There's a bit of a base there if there's some good hot tea there.
All right, let's jump on to the next one. Should we do a couple more? See how they go?
Yeah, just keep doing them.
All right, this is only 15 seconds.
We've been doing
so
2 weeks out, so let's make this cunt long.
Boys, what's doing? Just wanted to know what a day in the life of Simi and Jacko is during lockdown.
Grateful.
I want to come out of this thing feeling, looking fucking Mickey Mouse for summer.
Ooh.
See what you boys have for us. Love the potty.
Cheers, brother. Day in the life, Sim. You get started. And don't lie, because
lockdown-wise or just...
Well, there was kind of a two-part question there. He goes, what's a day in the life? And then he goes, he wants to come out of lockdown looking Mickey Mouse and feeling
so
fucking
day
dumb.
In the life for myself.
If you add any GST, I'm going to stop you as well. So be careful.
Cunt. You are GST. Day in the life for me is I wake up probably around 2-3 o'clock in the morning. I wake up, yeah, probably
about 2:30
in the morning every morning. I'll send out abusive messages to all the boys at YKTR.
Why I'm not happy.
Why I'm not happy and what needs to change and what I need, ASAP Rocky. Send out designs.
They don't get made, so I draw my own.
You know, I do all that, message all the boys. Fuck.
Mello. Oi. Sorry. This
cunt's barking. Yeah, get all that sort of sorted. Wake up baby girl probably around 5:36.
Yep.
We go down, we do Bondi to Bronte, then go for a swim, go for a little dip,
yep.
North Bondi. Then, you know, obviously with lockdown, if it's lockdown, I'll just jump on, speak to Jacko, knock out a few blogs, talk about what's going on during the week, talk about what's going on during the day, you know, and then not lockdown-wise, I'll probably just come straight into the office, get into it with the boys.
Bit of a potty.
Yeah, a bit of a potty, and then sort of just do work from home.
What do you do after work?
After work,
you get home.
I've
never even asked you.
Well, after I get home, I'll probably like, if I'm with baby girl, we'll probably just fucking, you know, cook a bit of dinner, talk a bit of shit, watch Love Island, watch all that jazz. But yeah, lockdown-wise, just fucking really nothing.
Nothing, yeah.
And then just watch TV shows, fucking throw a leg.
Yeah.
I'm the horniest cunt out, so
yeah.
Yeah, probably just do that and hit bed around probably about 9:30.
You have sex every day?
I try to. Yeah. Try to. I try twice a day, but sometimes it just doesn't get through.
Sometimes it doesn't get through to the keeper, man.
So yeah, I mean, if you don't try, you never know.
Yeah, fair enough.
But yeah,
average day for me. So I'm lucky in that I live across the road.
Be
from
honest
the office,
too,
so I am honest. So I mute my phone at about 3 a.m. so the simi stops calling me, and then I roll out of bed, bit of a sloth, 7:30, 7:15,
rank,
bit of oats, little protein oats. Roll into work, have a little meeting with Isaac, smack out a day's work. You've already seen what we do in a day here. Then I'll probably try and steal Mallow for the night, go for a little run, a few pull-ups at the old Alexandria bar. Look at me, son. You know I'm out there working.
Come on, man. Don't lie.
You know I'm out there working.
Don't lie.
I like to get a bit of a sweat on. And then, yeah, it's dinner with the miso. I'm pretty easy in lockdown, to be honest. Like, we don't see each other all day, so when we get home, we just fucking talk each other's ears off.
Mm.
And then, yeah, try and have a bit of sex, get denied, and turn over and go to bed. That's about the way it rolls.
Yeah, fair play.
So
if that's it was, kind of, if it wasn't,
I
lockdown,
wish we had. I wish we had more exciting life. Yeah, if it isn't lockdown,
I'd be in fucking. Ooh. I'd be in Perisher right now, fucking smashing this fucking snow.
we'd be in the Hunter Valley, fucking bottling up our first bottle of wine. All right, bro. Let's get to one more, eh? Before we leave here. Here we go.
Simi. I called a couple of weeks ago asking for advice. I've had a couple of babies. And just want to let you know.
Let's say ask
the rim job trick worked. Over. The rim job trick worked. You're a godsend. See you soon.
Is that the ass eating guy?
The ass eating guy from last.
So our advice works. It worked. Oh, congrats, brother.
Bro, one thing I will say, never ever call the hotline up like that again, you fucking scary cunt. Secondly, you're welcome. And thirdly,
lose my number.
Fuck, that was scary.
Hey, Simi.
Oh, cunt, that scared me.
Was
maybe
that
she was in the
while
other
he was
room.
Doing it?
I don't know, man. I don't know. I don't want to get straight into it, but man, that's what I'm trying to say. You've got to fucking, you have to fucking arch the hips sometimes. That was fucked. It actually gave me the worst anxiety
that
just hearing
me, that.
That
made me creeped out.
I thought it was someone going to fucking say they were going to kill me or something.
Oh. Anyway.
What the fuck?
We are going to now call a doozy member and give away all of this life appreciation stuff.
All of it.
All of it. We're going to give away.
Cheers, cheers. Oh, fuck.
Cheers, brother. One more in here.
Cheers.
Oh, fuck. It's good to be back, even though that was a weird way to end.
It almost every night. Fuck, man, my picks are unmatched.
But it's supernatural.
Alright, let's find us.
Body's dancing in the moonlight. Dancing in the moonlight.
Everybody else feeling warmer and brighter. Such a
holy cunt, I got lost in the cells.
Ooh, all right, should we do this?
Yeah, 100, 100, 100.
All right, I hope these people answer. Let's go.
Wait. So just give me a little fucking
top. No, it's all right. I just got to go random anyway.
Oh, okay.
I don't want to be fucking.
Oh, my cunt. Fuck, she's so sexy, man.
Who that, baby?
Oh, my God. Holy cunt. I've won the lotto, bro. I'm telling you. Oh, my fuck.
Because look. Oh, yeah, game over.
Oh, fuck, man. That's what I'm going home to.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. How can you be upset going home?
I'm not even upset, bro. I'm like, fuck, that's fucked.
All right. Let's just, okay. I'm just going to go random on this. Right. Better answer, you dog. We're trying to give you some clothes.
Is the whole kit?
Yeah, whole collection. You got it.
Okay.
Hello.
Hey, is this Jesse speaking?
Yeah, Jesse speaking.
Hey, bro, it's Jordan and Jackson, bro, from YKTR, man. Oh, how are you?
Shit. I don't believe you, bro.
Swear to God.
What do we need to do to prove it, man?
We're live on grass and a few reds, bro. So we're just, mate. We just thought we'd just give you a call up, bro, and let you know that you've won the fucking new life appreciation fucking.
Almighty Bucky.
Oh,
you've won it all, man. Works. You've won it all, bro.
The whole collection,
the whole collection, man.
I think it's 9 pieces, Jess.
Oh, that's awesome. Thank you very much, boys.
No worries, man. What are you doing, man?
I'm actually working.
You're still at work?
I work from home, so it's all good.
Oh, grouse.
What do you do for a crust, Jess?
Work as a parole officer.
Oh, fuck.
Shit. Oh, you must know Simi well, then.
Holy shit, how are you working from home? That's what I want to know. How do you work from home?
No, I can't comment on that.
No, all good, man. Hey, we just wanted to call up, obviously, let you know that you won the collection, the new drop, and we wanted to say, obviously, thanks for fucking backing us and following us and jumping on the Doozy Club.
Thank you very much, bro. It's the first thing I've won in my life, eh?
Fucking oath, man. It's actually a mad collection too.
Yeah, you'll love
it. It's popping. Awesome. It's fucking good fits, man. It's nice as so.
And it's about that lifestyle, man.
Looking for it.
It's just all I'm grateful.
Looking forward to it.
It's all grateful, man. Jacko will fucking hit you up and
I'll be in touch tomorrow, man.
Get your shit, but
awesome.
Yeah, man. Thank you so much. And obviously, when lockdown ends, we can all catch up for a few bevs and a few reds and a bit of grouse.
Yeah, I think I'll hit you up on Friday. I'll jump on Friday and say good day.
Oh, the old Friday drinks. Doozy Club,
sure,
baby.
For sure, man. Yeah. Jump on
and flex that you won and tell everyone else to fuck off.
Thank you awesome so much,
boys.
Brother.
Appreciate it.
Have
grateful
a good night, man.
All right, Jess. Later, brother.
Later, bro.
Thank you.
I love doing this shit, man. What else can we give away?
I thought you would have had a few other things to give away. Should we call the boss up and ask if we can chuck out a few vouchers? Call him up, ask him. Give him a call.
He's going to say, stop giving shit away.
Give him a call, man. See, fuck, hey, can we call him?
I don't want to call him and get in trouble. You always try and get me in trouble.
Call, bro. Like, you're 2IC. Fucking give the kind of call. Stop being a bitch.
Congratulations, Jesse. You've won the Life Appreciation Club. I'll tell you what, Sim. As much as you piss me off, man, it's good to be back. I enjoy this podcast. Man. This is the highlight of my fucking week.
No, likewise, man. Thank you very much, bro. Thank you very much.
And for that Friday drive home, man, we want you guys to sit back, enjoy it, know that you are special, you're worth it. Stay grateful.
Just love you guys, man. Thank you so much. Grateful. Cheers, man. Thank you. Cheers. Cheers. Ha. Oh, that's nice. One more.
Let it play. One more.
Quickly before we go, I wanted to say a special shout out and happy birthday to, he's like a little brother to me.
Yep.
Nick Theo. He's one of my first mates here in Sydney.
Birthday?
Yeah, it's his 21st, bro. 21st.
Happy birthday, brother. 21st.
So, yeah, man. He's a little legend, bro. He's fucking, he's an old soul. He's an old soul. I just wanted to just quickly say happy birthday. I love you, brother. Thanks for having my back. You're the best. Happy birthday, bro.
There you go. Happy birthday,
love you, man. Love you.